get up. What's the matter with you? All right, 19 minutes after 7 o'clock, and it's Wednesday, April 12th, 2017, and we are broadcasting live from the Paddock Mall just outside the WOZA Commissary. You can get a wrap made by Jimmy.
Yes, you can. He makes the best wrap.
57 degrees, temperatures today climbing to 83, partly cloudy skies, 56 the low tonight, 81 tomorrow, 84 Friday, 86 Saturday, Easter Sunday, 87 degrees. It's a beautiful time to be in Ocala, Florida. Good morning, everybody. Good morning, Robin.
Good morning, Larry.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. All right. Let me tell you what we're doing after we get done with all this intro stuff. 7:35, we'll talk about the news. There are news items to talk about, to offer opinions on, to enlighten ourselves with other people's opinions about, and we'll do that at 7:35. 8:05, Galen Unold will be on with us from Life South Community Blood Centers. I quite often feel that I do things my way and only come to find out that I'm wrong. I do things wrong, like, all the time, or at least so I'm told. Mm-hmm. And so I have here a list of 10 things that I'm glad I realized I was doing wrong. 10 things that I'm glad I realized I was doing wrong.
Oh, wow.
So we'll find out about that and share them with you, and you share yours with me, because there's got to be some. That's got to be true for all of us. I can't be the only one on the planet who figured out, oh, I was doing it wrong. Oh, I'm so glad you told me how to do it.
Oh, I'm in your playpen, let me tell you.
I'm a playpen?
I'm in your playpen.
Oh, you're in my playpen.
Yeah.
I like that. Think
I'm told that I'm, you know, doing things wrong too, so can't wait to hear.
Well, that's true for all of us. Mm-hmm. But, I mean, have you ever had the thing that you were told and you say, oh, you are right. I am doing it wrong. Let me do it your way. Ah. So much better.
Yes.
The CPR is now working. My patient is finally coming to life. That actually happened to me, by the way.
Oh,
it was a dummy. It wasn't a real patient. It was a class, a CPR class. I was doing it wrong, Robin.
Oh, my God.
If it hadn't been a rubber person... It would have been just as good as a rubber purse. All right. 8:35 this morning, News Bites. This is when we turn off any attempt to be entertaining, any attempt to be political pugnance. Pugnance? What's the word? Pundits.
Pundits.
Pugnance. Pugnant. Repugnant. Anyway, you know what that is. We read the news. Raydene Trees Nehring has been with us before. She is an award-winning author, a journalist who contributes to lots of different publications, and she's got a music... She's got a book called Music to Die For. So we'll find out about that at 9:05. 9:20, Betty Jean Craig is coming on to talk about her book called Damn Witherston.
Yeah.
Damn Witherston. Betty Craig writes for the Athens Banner Herald up in Athens, Georgia,
it's
correct?
Pretty cool, yes.
So relatively local. Relatively mm-hmm. local. Gary Shapiro is coming on. Isn't this the lawyer for somebody? He's the president and CEO of the every time I see the name Shapiro, I think
it's
a lawyer.
I know. They must have a huge family. They're all attorneys.
He's a contributor to the Wall Street Journal, the New York Times, the Washington Post. You get the idea. He's going to talk about the Consumer Technology Association's new innovation scorecard.
Mm-hmm.
They have some findings for each state. We'll find out how Florida did regarding innovation. Well, hello. You better have some good stuff for us, because I know we've innovated some things here.
Exactly.
You don't always give us credit, but we have. 9:50, David Leite, I'll say it that way until I find out differently, L-E-I-T-E, I don't know how it's really pronounced. He's a chef. He's talking about his book called Notes on a Banana.
Yeah, it's a memoir. It's pretty interesting.
You know, time flies like an arrow. Just thought I'd say that. This is his memoir of food, love, and manic depression. I don't know that I want this guy making my food.
No, that's how he adjusted throughout his life, was
eating?
Doing food.
Eating?
With his mom, having nice things with his mom, so... Pretty cool and pretty interesting.
Dr. Susan Barbara Apollon is an intuitive psychologist. What does that mean?
Wonder if she can read our mind as soon as she gets on, if she can feel the vibes. when she gets on.
She's got a book called An Inside Job. A psychologist shares healing wisdom for your cancer journey. Oh, that's a serious topic.
Yeah.
1035 Renewal by Anderson of Central Florida. This is an infomercial. You hear it every Wednesday at 1035 on WOCA. It is a, it's one of the good ones. Mm-hmm. It's one of the good ones. They're not trying to sell you a knife that'll cut through shoes.
No, Ted Turner did that already.
Yeah,
that's old.
What they do is they install the window people, and they are here. They're local window people, and they do their show differently than most of the people who do shows on WOCA come in here and do that. They record their own, and that's the only difference, really. They offer a discount for you when you use their 800 number. So. Use the 800 number. That's the advice if you're looking for windows. We've had some good feedback from some of you, mm-hmm. which is good because we want to make sure that the people who are sponsoring this station are, you know, meeting our standards. So thank you for giving us the feedback.
Mm-hmm.
Dr. Michael Bergdorf at 1105. He is a board-certified plastic surgeon. He's going to talk about his book called The Mommy Makeover.
Yep.
Restoring Your Body After Childbirth. The voice of travel, Anthony James, talking about going from here to there. It's Easter weekend. You might go someplace for the Easter holiday, perhaps.
Yeah.
I know a lot of people do. Fun with Joe today. It's just another day of more useless trivia.
Yes.
It's another day in paradise. Useless trivia is the topic today on Fun with Joe, so that ought to be fun.
I think so.
And let's see, what else do we have? Oh, the Ocala Business Leaders are having a ribbon-cutting event this morning. In about 35 minutes, the breakfast apparently has already gotten started. The ribbon cutting will be at the Ocala Elks Lodge, 286. Is this where Joe is right now?
Yes.
So if you want to go out there, I think everybody's invited, correct?
Yes, everybody is.
Joe Martone is the president of the Ocala Business Leaders, and he's also here. He's mm-hmm. our, what do we call him, general manager, owner? He's everything here.
Yes, everything.
The Ocala Business Leaders. Hey, by the way, if I could just throw in a plug for being a member of Ocala Business Leaders, one of the keys to success in business, I'm not saying it's the only one, and I'm not saying it's a must, but it really is helpful if you network with other people.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the best ways to network with other people is to join a group like Ocala Business Leaders. They have a really good group of people. I've met most of them. And if you're interested in becoming a member, you can join them this morning for the ribbon cutting. You can have breakfast on them if it's not too late. Get there, the scrambled eggs might be cold, but they're probably still there. The Elk Lodge number is 286, and it's at 702 Northeast 25th Avenue. So if you have a business, you want to kind of network with other business people. Again, you know, we have this topic later on with Galen. You know, what have I done? What things I'm glad I discovered I was doing wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Well, this applies to business. How many times have we spared ourselves the agony of a whole year simply by finding out the mistakes somebody else made?
That's right.
And if they point out to us what we've done wrong, or maybe you've got something. Maybe you're going to take something to the table. And you're going to bump into somebody else who does the same thing you do, and you're going to say, you know, I'm new here, but just something I'm observing. And if a smart person will listen to a smart person.
Exactly.
You know?
It's the truth.
You can roll your eyes at somebody, and sometimes that's appropriate too, but a lot of times. Anyway, so this morning, if you want to go there, 702 Northeast 25th Avenue. I thought I'd throw that in there.
Nice.
So I do have something I wanted to play. It's not really heavy news, but do you remember this song?
Oh, yeah, I do.
Great song. Love the song.
Yeah.
Does she walk? Does she talk? Does she come complete? My homeroom angel.
Well, there you go. That's John Giles. The band was called the J. Giles Band, and John Giles died. He was 71 years old. Yeah. Anyway, what was that song called? Centerfold was the name
yes.
of the song.
Yes.
They had a bunch of hits. That was actually one of their more pop hits. They were kind of a really heavy rock band. Do you remember that?
Yeah, I do.
Check out.
Yeah.
Let's see. He died at his home in Groton, Massachusetts, according to the report. He was 71 years old. It said natural causes on the news. I'm looking to see if it gives you something specific, but it does not. He grew up listening to artists like Count Basie, Louis Armstrong, Duke Ellington. He studied Miles Davis tunes on trumpet and drums and played trumpet at Northeastern University. He eventually became attracted to the folk scene in Boston, as most young people did back in those days. Then he discovered rock music, so that's, he kind of had a, he was sampling all of the different styles, I suppose, as a young man. He had the band members included Magic Dick Salwitz. That was the name we all laughed at back in those days.
Yeah.
He played the harmonica, remember that? Peter Wolf was in that band, you might remember him. Stephen Joe Blad and Seth Justman, they were all part of the Jay Giles band. John Giles, dead at 71. We'll take a little break. Be right back. This is The Source, WOCA.
It's okay, I understand. This ain't no never, never land. Hold up when this issue's gone. I'll see you when you're close.
Fox News Radio, I'm Rich Dennison. Secretary of State Rex Tillerson's in Moscow today, meeting with his Russian counterpart, Foreign Minister Sergey Lavrov.
Our meetings today come at an important moment in the relationship so that we can further clarify areas of common objectives, areas of common interest, even when our tactical approaches may be different.
Tensions between Washington and the Kremlin are high as the two nations disagree over issues in Syria. The CEO of United Airlines' parent company pledging to review company policies after a passenger was forcibly dragged off an overbooked flight in Chicago Sunday. In his latest apology for the incident, Oscar Munoz says no one should be mistreated that way. Another loss in the music world. John Giles, founder of the Jay Giles Band, found dead in his Massachusetts home yesterday. It appears the 71-year-old died of natural causes. Fox News, we report, you decide.
Wildfires burn millions of acres each year. And each year, wildland firefighters like Fire Chief James Hall battle to contain them. But they can't do it alone.
A single ember that escapes from a wildfire can travel more than a mile. It can ignite and destroy your home, your community, or more. That single ember can be just as dangerous as the wildfire itself. But you can do something firefighters can't. You can act now to prepare your home and your community for wildfire. You can reduce the risk. Do your part. Go to fireadapted.org.
Get fire adapted. Learn what you can do now to reduce wildfire damage later at fireadapted.org. A public service message brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service and the Ad Council. Learn more at fireadapted.org.
Next Generation MD is the future of healthcare now. Listen in the first and third Thursday at 10 a.m. to learn how the future in PRP treatments are here in our area. Find out the many ways that Dr. Juan Jordan, MD, Charles Brooks, NP, and case manager Mark Shaw have brought the family medicine practice to a new level. Hear from the very people that benefit from the fine work they have done in this field. Next Generation MD, every first and third Thursday at 10 a.m. here on WOCA 96.3 FM, 1370 AM, The Source.
What you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
Car dealerships, they either want to make up for a slow weekend or keep their hot sales streak going, so they're more willing to wheel and deal on a Monday. Would you rather save 2 minutes getting to your destination faster or save a few $100 in gas and get where you're going in one piece by sticking to one lane? Most weddings back in the day were held on a weekday. In fact, nobody wanted to get married on a Saturday. And if you choose a weekday wedding now, you're going to save big.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
Don't get caught without your daily source of senior deals. Pick up your copy of the Senior Voice newspaper. It's your source for schedule and events tailored to seniors with information you need, like a list of free events in the area. We even have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company to you that fits your needs. And all we ask in return is that you tell them where you heard about them. For more information, call Tom's Picks, 352-804-1223. And pick up your copy of the Senior's Voice at most any business up and down the 200 corridor.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
Hi.
Hospice of Marion County has an urgent need for volunteers to share a conversation with someone, run errands, hold someone's hand. All you need is a willingness to help others. Our volunteers believe the blessings they receive far exceed the services they offer. Will you consider serving, caring, and making a difference? Call today, 873-7441. Hospice of Marion County, making more moments of life possible.
Hi, this is Vanessa Lane Jennings with the Jennings Law Firm, located here in beautiful Ocala. Join me every single Friday at 10:30 for Legal Lane. We'll be discussing various legal topics such as family law, criminal law, contracts, and much more. So this is your chance to call in with your legal questions and have them answered. That's every Friday, 10:30, right here, WOCA The Source.
Veterans are the foundation upon which our freedom is built. Listen to The Source, WOCA, each Thursday at 9 a.m. to Veterans News with Hank Whittier from Vets Helping Vets. You'll hear tributes, information on veterans' issues, and stories that will make you laugh, cry, and feel proud. Veterans News always focuses on the military, past and present, and on our first responders. Veterans News is brought to you each week by Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens and Nursery, keeping you blooming since 1952.
All right, 25 minutes before 8 o'clock. Thank you for tuning in this Wednesday morning. Gosh, I got to think what day it is. 57 degrees here at the studios, broadcasting live, of course, from the Paddock Mall. Looks like a nice day. 83 is the high. 56 is the low tonight. Partly cloudy skies. Just take what I just said, copy and paste it to tomorrow, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. That's the forecast the whole time. And the one day or the 2 days, it's always the weekend, right? And this weekend, especially because it's Easter weekend, if you are going to any of the state parks for a family gathering, the advice from the state park system is to arrive early. Oh my gosh. Yes. I've actually discovered this, there's a few state parks. When Robin and I were going to the state parks, a few years ago, we were painting plein air landscapes to raise money for the Literacy Council, which, by the way, we're volunteering to raise money for the Literacy Council again this year. So I want to, for the Kiss the Horse thing, so I want to tell you about that later. But anyway, we went to the different state parks. Remember this, Robin? And we would get to the park and there'd be a line.
Yeah.
You say, you're kidding. A state park is filled? Mm-hmm. Yes, it's filled. And you would have to wait there or just say, forget it and go someplace else.
That's right.
And the other part of this, too. Now, Silver Springs might be one of the exceptions to this. There's two reasons why I think Silver Springs might not have a problem.
Mm-hmm.
Because, first of all, they don't have a swimming area.
Right.
And I know we all want a swimming area, and I'm with you on that. I would love to see a swimming area over there. So,
mm-hmm.
But the fact that we don't have one right now, and we will not have one on Easter Sunday,
mm-hmm.
Means that those people who are looking for a beautiful place to go to swim, like Rainbow Springs, for example,
or is it
Leon Springs?
Yes.
Anyway, all the state parks that have swimming areas are packed.
They are absolutely packed.
They are packed on Easter weekend. If the weather is as beautiful this weekend as it is today, mm-hmm. which it looks like it will be, yeah, it's going to be hard. So you have to arrive early. And
very early.
there's two strategies here. One strategy is to have a designated early arriver, because the early arriver can go in and kind of grab a table, because a lot of times you want the picnic table, right?
Mm-hmm, right.
So the early arriver is the one who says, okay, this is our picnic table, and you got to sit there in the misty, foggy, beautiful morning, which is, gosh, it's beautiful in those parks in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
But then you got to wait for the rest of the people. Unfortunately, some of the other people might not be able to get in.
That's right.
Because that's part of the problem. I'm just kind of giving you a heads up if you've never done it. First of all, it's a beautiful way to spend Easter, because you're with your family and you're in a beautiful place.
Exactly.
But the other part is, it is kind of a very, very... you're not the only one with the idea. That's the reason. You're not the only one with that idea. So.
And they will turn you away.
Well, or they'll tell you to wait.
Yeah.
You're sometimes you have to wait. And it's not always easy, especially if it's not noon yet.
Yeah.
If you get there before noon, chances are not too many people are leaving the park.
Right.
So you'll be sitting out there a while. So use your cell phone. Hey, they won't let me in. You know, sometimes they will let you walk in, though.
Yes.
If you can park, like if you can find a parking lot outside of the park and you're up to the walk, if it depends on how far it is,
mm-hmm.
they will let you walk in. It's just that the parking spaces are filled. So that's another tip. But the two reasons why Silver Springs might not be a problem is because they don't have a swimming area. That's number one. And number two, they've got two parking areas. Remember, don't forget they've got two parking areas because it used to be two parks.
Right.
So the Silver Springs part that used to be the attraction has, you know, a rather large parking lot.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And then the other half, the part that used to be called the Silver River State Park,
mm-hmm.
they've got... It's not that big, is it? Their parking lots are not that big.
No. Mm-mm.
But they have parking spaces back there. So, and I think they have a shuttle that goes back and forth between the two areas. So
I think so. I think.
But
they
the
do.
But the side of Silver Springs. Correct me if I'm wrong, and I may be wrong because I haven't been there in probably a year now.
Mm-hmm.
Has it been about a year? You think?
I think so.
The picnic tables are more abundant on the Silver River side, right?
Mm-hmm.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Although they did start putting picnic tables in on the Silver Springs. I don't know.
Yeah, they did. Just up to where you walk in, they started putting them right there and on back.
Just a couple of thoughts on that regard. Mm-hmm. Anyway, the weather should be nice. All right, let's see. What are we doing here? Oh, I will tell you about our Kiss the Horse thing later on. Should I tell them now?
Okay.
Yeah, tell them now?
Yeah.
Well, we'll make an official promotion.
Okay.
With this.
All right.
But here's the idea we have this year. This is the idea. Robert and I did a brainstorming thing. We didn't want to do the same thing we've done before. Here's what we've done in the past for the Literacy Council.
Uh-huh.
We did plein air painting.
Yep.
Which, Frank, if you're listening, you made us the winners on that one.
Thank you.
I got to kiss the horse.
Yes, you did.
Another year we busked for a bus, meaning we played as street musicians, and the police looked at us very funny.
Yeah.
Because you're not allowed to be playing for tips on the streets of Ocala, which is also what busking means, is playing for tips. And if they ever saw somebody give us a dollar, they would turn the car around. What are you doing?
That's right. They would go around
the
block.
This is for the Literacy Council. And we'd recognize the police officer. Oh, it's you two.
Yeah, right.
Well, yeah, it's us too. We're raising money. I'll never forget. We were sitting outside the Habitat for Humanity store. Mm-hmm. This Brad Nemo was still alive at that time.
And, yeah. We were by the street.
And he had invited us to go play outside their store. Okay, mm-hmm. So we set up a sign, which was a professionally made sign that says we're, you know, raising money for the Literacy Council. We're playing music. Nobody can hear us because everybody's in cars. Nobody.
Yeah.
We don't have pedestrians in Ocala, apparently.
Not
so,
there.
So, and not anywhere. So, except that light up Ocala, then everybody's walking in the streets.
Yeah, right.
Okay. But anyway, so this lady comes up to us, and if you can just picture the bitchiest face on anybody. I hate to use the word, but a mean face doesn't work.
No.
Bitchy face works.
Yes.
So bitchy face lady comes up to us with $2. $2. And she says, as long as you don't use it for drugs and alcohol, here it is. And I said to her, would you read the sign, please? Do we look like we're addicted to anything at all other than maybe, you know, cheeseburgers?
Right. Yeah, she was that way.
It was fun. So we did the plein air painting. We did we busked for a bus. We did the Oompa surprise. That was 1 year.
That was fun.
I don't can't remember what else we did. But anyway, so this year what we're doing is we want to draw a crowd.
Yes.
Okay, we want to draw a crowd. We have this paper that is 36 inches wide and 75 feet long.
Yes.
Okay? We want to fill that paper up with sketches that I will do of anybody who donates $10 to the Literacy Council.
Yes.
So your little face will be one of many, many faces. And I'll put your name under your face if you want me to.
Yes.
And then I'm going to have you, your caricature, holding a sign.
It'll be fun looking.
It'll be fun looking. Yes.
Yeah.
Don't expect me to do a perfect likeness, although I'm pretty good. I'm pretty good with getting a likeness. So it'll sort of kind of look like you. Okay. And so in some cases it'll look dead on, cuz sometimes I just like, "Whoa, that looks just like you," you know?
Yeah.
Other times you're going to say, "No, that doesn't look like me at all." But it's all for a good cause. So this gigantic piece of paper. Now I'm thinking if we can get 1,000 people on there, that's $10,000 for the Literacy Council.
Yes.
Right? And we're going to set up, we don't have anything set up yet at all, so we're going to try to set up a GoFundMe page or something.
Yeah.
So that you can do it with your phone or whatever you do. So, it ought to be fun. What do you think? We got, what, a month and a half to do this?
Is that
how much time we have?
Yeah, Summer said somewhere around the end of May. So
the end of May?
She's not sure. So
well, this is
like,
the middle of April, so that's a month and a half.
Yep, that's right. Exactly.
All right, month and a half.
And it's from a photograph, so it'll be so cool.
Yeah.
$10 minimum. Yeah.
Listen to you.
Well, we're fundraising for the Literacy
Council. All right, let's look at the news.
None of that money goes to us.
Right, I know.
For sure.
All right, here we go. Here's the news that we can talk about. Secretary of State Rex Tillerson is in Moscow today.
Okay.
He is expected to meet with Russian officials, and they will be talking about ending the civil war in Syria. And perhaps the presidency of Syrian President Bashar Assad.
Mm-hmm.
Our president has used his, this is me interpreting this now, our president has used his negotiating skills, his deal-making skills, and when Putin says that what we've done is an act of war, Trump said to him, well, I'll tell you what, you can either have Bashar Assad as your pal or us as your pal. Pick sides. One or the other.
I love that.
So that's him doing a deal.
He's
that's
strong.
What he's good at. You may not agree with it, but that's what he's doing. Anyway, Russian President Vladimir Putin may be more open to a deal after Assad's alleged use of chemical weapons on a rebel-held village. That statement, actually, from USA Today, which is typically a liberal-leaning, an anti-Trump-leaning publication, just so you know. Tillerson and Russia yesterday, Tillerson said yesterday that Russia has to choose between aligning itself with the United States and other Western nations or Assad.
Well, I'd rather stand up than roll over, so kudos to Trump for being the stand-up guy.
There's another title for a book, Robin. I'd rather stand up than roll over. I'd rather be a sparrow than a snail. What's that song? I'd rather be
Paul Simon's song, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, he is the same.
All right, we've got to move forward.
Okay.
We'll take a little break. We've got more real news on the other side. That was a little bit of real news. I think we occupied most of our segment with other stuff. All right, we'll be right back.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Safe boating is no accidents. On this Wednesday, sunshine and some clouds. Highs in the upper 70s at the coast, 85 inland. Clear to partly cloudy Wednesday night. Lows in the mid-50s inland, mid-60s along the coast. Thursday, partly sunny. Highs in the upper 70s along the coast, low 80s inland. Friday, partly sunny and becoming breezy in the afternoon with a stray shower. High 80 at the coast, 85 inland. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
Hey, this is Matt Wilkerson from Verizon. You work all day, right? So why would you want to spend your night out shopping for that new phone? Well, Marion County, let me and Verizon help you out. I can deliver to your home or office, saving you precious time. Phone, tablets, internet, home phones, even accessories. Whatever you need, we will deliver free of charge. Call me at the store, 352-528-0020. That's 528-0020.
The very best in quality is Captain T's Upholstery.
Hey, this is Dan. Let me ask you a few questions. Does your boat look better with the cover on? Has your car's interior seen its better days? Stop using a towel to cover up those rips in the golf cart. Isn't it about time you had it restored to better than new with a custom upholstery from Captain T? Captain T's Upholstery has been right here in Ocala for nearly 20 years, so they know how to make your ride one of a kind. Whether you want to take that classic ride back to a factory look or put your favorite sports team front and center, Captain T's Upholstery is who to call. 352-369-1810. That's 352-369-1810. Or stop by their location, 5030 South Pine Avenue in Ocala, just past the drive-in. And of course, don't forget to visit them on the web, CaptainTUpholstery.com.
The very best in quality is Captain T's Upholstery.
Have you heard of Hyper Directory? When looking for local businesses, go to hyper.directory. No need for triple W, no need for .com, just hyper.directory. Connecting customers to local companies when it matters most. Hyper Directory is your local business directory partnered with the Ocala Chamber and Economic Partnership to bring you trusted local businesses. Keeping Ocala local. Use hyper.directory. No triple W, not even .com. Just hyper.directory. Connecting customers to businesses when it matters most.
All right, 12 minutes before 8 o'clock. Nice, beautiful Wednesday morning in Ocala. 57 degrees. Temperatures today climbing, expected to climb to 83 degrees. And as I mentioned before, copy that and paste it to the rest of the forecast because every day it looks the same, which means that Easter Sunday, Easter weekend, looks like it's going to be a beautiful weekend. Every day is going to be a beautiful day. The only problem is we do need rain, but I guess we can ask God to hold off, I guess, till after Easter, huh? Let's get back to some of these news stories. The next one, it's been an off-limits subject for Caitlyn Jenner, but now it's out. People Magazine reports it has confirmed that Jenner's as-yet unreleased memoir will acknowledge that she indeed did have a sex change operation. I have audio from the surgery.
Sorry. Should have had a little bit more high pitch.
That is actually in the news, not the audio clip. That was Shemp, by the way.
Oh, okay.
A new webpage reveals for the first time exactly how care at every VA hospital and clinic across the country compares with nearby private sector hospitals and national averages. The site, which goes live today, also shows if veterans are satisfied with their wait times at each facility and how long they are actually waiting on average. Really? The article does not give the website.
Oh.
But anyway, we'll look it up. We'll try to find it for you. You can probably look it up yourself. So I would guess, I'm just going to guess, that our VA here in our community has good grades. I'm just going to guess.
Yeah, I believe they're one of the best. I
also can attribute that to Hank Whittier and to Vets Helping Vets in general.
Yep.
Because I remember when they first started doing the radio show with us, which is probably going on 14 years now, I can remember it was an issue. But once they started going public, once they started doing the show, and in a way it's a little pat on our back, but we did nothing other than give them airtime. Which is a big thing actually. But anyway, so but they started, you know, making waves.
Yeah.
You know, started pushing back, started saying, hey, you're making us wait too long. We don't like it. And the VA has, we've had nothing but good stories from the VA here. So.
Yeah. And Dr. Mark Knapp has been there the whole time, and he was instrumental in that too. So thank you.
President Trump is not expected to show up at the New York Auto Show this week, but his presence will be felt with the reveal of every new model. Many of the cars making their debut at the show are larger and thirstier. There's a political commentary in an article that didn't need a political commentary.
Exactly.
Anyway, the media preview day begins today. Automakers will unveil new hot models, already out, a hybrid police car and a new Jeep.
Oh, okay.
A hybrid police car and a new Jeep.
Yeah, that's two opposite ends of the spectrum.
You can't buy a police car, but you can buy a Jeep.
Yes, you can.
I've often thought I'd like a Jeep.
Yeah, a real Jeep.
Real Jeep.
Yeah.
Big
Jeep.
Yeah,
one of those with big tires.
Yeah.
Go through the mud.
I'll wear brown clothing.
That's right.
The National Hockey League's two-month quest for the Stanley Cup begins today at 7 p.m. when the Boston Bruins visit the Ottawa Senators and the Montreal Canadiens host the New York Rangers.
Okay.
By the way, there was a story this morning about a hockey player who died, whose wife spread his ashes in the penalty box.
Oh.
It was something he wanted. Well, she wasn't being mean, in case you think so.
Uh-huh.
She wasn't being mean. I have that somewhere in here. But
they actually allowed that.
Not all of his ashes, just some of his ashes. Some, yeah. Oh. That's what he wanted, apparently. Apparently, it was a very touching ceremony and everything. But
that's nice. I like that.
The penalty box, you would think, it almost sounds like she was like getting back at him or something. For,
yeah, right, right.
Anyway.
Well, maybe it was one of those players that liked to fight, and they said, go in the box.
Yeah, you
know?
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
probably what it was. He liked to fight, so.
United Airlines attempt Monday to quell mounting outrage over viral videos of the passenger that was dragged from his seat. Added fuel to the backlash against the airline. Yesterday, CEO Oscar Munoz called the event truly horrific in a second apology. But while United was crafting another bid to defuse the situation, the flood of angry comments and memes on social media was replaced by tough questions from local and federal authorities and a mention of the incident even by President Trump. Which, of course, he will mention anything that gets his attention, it seems like. Meanwhile, David Dow, that's the man who was pulled off of the plane, by the way, now has a high-powered attorney.
Ben, is it Shapiro?
No, it's Thomas Demetrio, a Chicago personal injury attorney. Thomas Demetrio. Well, if you're an attorney, today we love you.
Yeah, exactly.
We want an attorney to be representing this guy.
Yeah.
Dow was in a Chicago hospital undergoing treatment for his injuries yesterday, according to a statement from Demetrio, who is helping represent Dow and his family. Demetrio's practice centers on medical negligence, product liability, airplane crash, and commercial litigation on behalf of plaintiffs, and he has negotiated more than $1 billion in settlements, according to the firm's website. There you go.
There, he's going to win a huge amount.
By the way, that whole incident has cost United Airlines in stock value. The airline was valued at about $22.4 billion at the close of trading on Monday.
Mm-hmm.
At around noon on Tuesday, it had sunk to $21.92 billion.
Wow.
A loss of more than $500 million. By the close of trading, its value had recovered a little bit, $22.25
billion.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Well, I'm sure the public is going to look to fly other airlines, and that airline will be the last resort that they buy a ticket on.
Today.
Yeah.
People forget. Give it a week.
Yeah,
give
right.
it a month, maybe.
Yeah.
People will forget.
Yeah.
White House Press Secretary Sean Spicer apologized yesterday for suggesting Syrian President Bashar al-Assad was worse than Hitler and incorrectly stating Hitler did not use chemical weapons during World War II. Oh, my gosh.
How could you say he
didn't use chemical weapons?
Wow.
What do you think those gas chambers were?
Wow. Wow. He didn't think it through. He was off the cuff. He was in the moment. Gee.
The estranged stepfather of a Wisconsin man suspected of stealing guns and threatening attacks in an anti-government manifesto sent to the White House urged his former stepson to surrender. Don McLean. Not the American Pie Don McLean.
Okay.
Said his stepson, I hope it's not that Don McLean, Joseph Jakubowski, has never had a good relationship with police and that he and his wife are concerned for his safety. We just want him to give up, said McLean. There's no good ending to this except him giving up. Yeah, he's true. He's right.
Exactly, because he'll die.
That's right.
They'll kill him.
That's right. Just give up. Yep. Get it over with. Put that behind you. You made a big mistake. It's talking about mistakes. We're going to do that with Galen later on.
Mm-hmm.
Things I did wrong that I'm glad somebody pointed out.
Yeah.
The Florida state prosecutor who was removed from 23 murder cases by Governor Scott for refusing to consider the death penalty.
Mm-hmm.
She herself has filed a federal lawsuit seeking to reverse his order.
Oh, my God.
Saying it was unconstitutional. She is, as you know, Aramis Ayala. She took office in January. Many of those cases, in fact, all of those cases, were sent down here to Ocala to our state attorney here, Brad King.
Yes, he's a good guy.
So she didn't want them, and the governor sent them to him, and now she's suing for that motion, that act.
It's all right, she'll lose. Because you can't formulate an opinion before you do the trial. So she was wrong.
Let's see. United Airlines told federal regulators in 2014 that all ticketed passengers were guaranteed seats.
There you go.
Just use the headline. Don't need to read any more on that one.
That's right.
The bat maternity season starts April 16th. I didn't even know we had this.
I didn't either, but this is interesting.
The bat maternity season in Florida starts April 16th. It runs through August 14th. If you have bats in your attic, they've got to stay there.
Oh.
You cannot move a bat in the state of Florida if it's having babies up in your attic.
Oh, gee.
Did you know this?
I did not know that. Not at all.
Homeowners and building managers who need to exclude bats roosting in their homes or other structures can do so as long as it is not done during maternity season.
Wow.
What?
Wow.
The season starts April 16th and lasts through August 14th.
What? Wow. We've got till Sunday to get rid of them then.
If you have bats in your attic, you
you better do it.
Yeah,
now.
You got to wait till August 15th.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
What's that sound bite from Bruce Jenner? We'll be right back. We'll be right back. This is The Source, WOCA, Ocala. There is music in here somewhere.
Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Carol McHugh. Let there be no doubt, the president says last week's missile strike on a Syrian airbase was a long time coming.
What I did should have been done by the Obama administration a long time before I did it. And you would have had a much better, I think Syria would be a lot better off right now than it has been.
President Trump speaking with Maria Bartiromo on the Fox Business Network. The attack was a response to a Syrian chemical attack on its own people. In Moscow, the Secretary of State has met with his Russian counterpart.
Secretary Tillerson saying he's in Moscow.
So that we can further clarify areas of common objectives, areas of common interests.
Tillerson saying he hopes to clarify what he calls sharp differences. The Russian foreign minister accusing the U.S. of having a muddled approach to world affairs.
Fox's Simon Owen. The president of China phones President Trump to say let's find a peaceful solution to the North Korean nuke program. Fox News, we report, you decide.
My name is Dale Pazinski. I'm 19 years old, and this is how I live United. I've always been kind of a computer geek, and I found a way to use those skills to help the homeless in my community. For people facing hard times, computer skills and a basic resume are so important. It may seem like a small thing, but it makes a huge difference in people's lives. So with United Way, I created a program where I work with the homeless. Together, we go through their whole job history, write a resume, and then save it on their very own USB drive. We provide workbooks and training certificates. I even budgeted for cupcakes so we can celebrate as a class when one of our people gets a job. That's huge. When somebody says, hey man, that job that you helped me apply for, I got it. That's what living United feels like to me. My name is Dale Pazinski. I help people achieve financial independence. So I don't just wear the shirt, I live it.
Give, advocate, volunteer, live United. Go to liveunited.org. Brought to you by United Way and the Ad Council.
Hi, this is JP from Penn Flooring here in Ocala. I would like to invite you to come in and visit our spacious showroom where we have solutions for every style and budget. From wall-to-wall carpet to hardwood floors and tiles, we have an unsurpassed selection of flooring. At Penn Flooring, we've provided quality customer service with a family touch for over 25 years. Visit our website at pennflooring.com or come by our showroom, 1201 Southwest 17th Street, just over the bridge. Penn Flooring, quality customer service with a family touch.
Buying and selling? Then you know about OcalaForSale.com, Marion County's internet marketplace. But there's something you might not know. I'm Michael Warren, president of USA for Sale. We created Ocala for Sale in 1998 with a passion to connect buyers and sellers and to help local businesses reach shoppers online. On Ocala for Sale, you're just a click away from thousands of deals for real estate, rentals, cars, furniture, appliances, horses, pets.